Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. As you might have heard, since a few days, Microsoft has released their 2023 update of Windows 11, better known as 23H2. As I did some earlier videos on getting Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, this one is no different and covers upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 on non-supported hardware. There are several scenarios that might apply for you, so I decided to split these up in separate videos to avoid confusion. This video is about upgrading from Windows 10 to the latest version of Windows 11 23H2. Other videos will be about performing a fresh installation of Windows 11 23H2 on unsupported hardware, or about upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 when you would already be on a previous Windows 11 version. For these different scenarios, I've put a card here and you can find a link in the description as well. Since Microsoft released Windows 11 in October 2021, there has been some hardware limitations. These limitations include a limited list of processor support, the requirement for a secure boot, and a TPM 2.0 module. In case one of these requirements on your machine is not met, you have an unsupported system, and without any workarounds, you will not be able to install Windows 11 on your machine. For this video, I will use my trusty Dell OptiPlex 9020, which I also used for previous videos on Windows 11. It is equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, which is not supported, and it doesn't meet the TPM 2.0 requirement either. So in short, this machine is not officially compatible or qualified to run Windows 11 by Microsoft, and currently it is still running on Windows 10. When going to About This PC, we can see all of this. The 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, and that we are currently on Windows 10. Looking at Windows Update, we can see that all available updates for this machine were installed. If you want to go through this as well, I would definitely recommend here to make sure you first install all pending updates before continuing. This is not a strict requirement, but sometimes it results in strange behavior after the upgrade. We can also see a banner here to tell us that our machine does not meet the minimum system requirements to upgrade to Windows 11. As the banner says as well, we can use the PC Health app to check why that is the case. I pre-installed this application, so let's launch it and see what it has to say. After clicking on Check Now here, as we already knew, it tells us that we don't meet the requirements because we don't have a TPM 2.0 module and our processor is too old. There wouldn't be a reason for this video if I wouldn't have a way around this, of course. The way we will do this is by downloading the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft's website, copy the contents to our SSD, and modify a single file which is responsible for the hardware checks. This will allow us to continue and upgrade our current Windows 10 installation, even though officially the hardware is not supported. So, let's start our browser and head over to Microsoft's Windows 11 download page. You have several options here, and earlier, for 22H2, I recommended to continue here by downloading the ISO with the Media Creation tool. For Windows 11 23H2, I noticed that if you use an ISO that is generated with that tool, it would only upgrade to 22H2, and you'd need to further work around the upgrade limitation from there. That's not a disaster, but since we need to download a lot anyway, it's easier and faster to instead download the ISO directly from here. So, select the only option in the Download Windows 11 Disk Image part, Windows 11 Multi-Edition ISO from the list, and click Download. Now comes the tricky part. We need to select the correct language for the ISO, and that's more important than you might think, as it has to match with the base installed language of your current installation, which does not necessarily matches with the current display language. In order to double check which one that is, we need to launch a command prompt as administrator. To do so, press the Windows key or Start button and type CMD. This should select the command prompt and click on Run as Administrator here. Here we can type the command dism /online/get-entl and press enter. In the output you get here, you should find the base language of your Windows installation. In my case, it is English United States, so that is the language I need to select for the download. After selecting the correct language, click confirm and wait for the 64-bit download button to appear. Then click on it to start downloading the ISO file. While we wait for the download to complete, it's maybe worth mentioning here as well, as I got that question a few times on previous videos, that there is no upgrade path from a 32-bit Windows 10 install. In that case, only a fresh installation will work for you. Our download completed in the meanwhile, so we can close our browser and navigate to the downloads folder to continue. Now we need to mount that downloaded ISO file. This can simply be done by double-clicking on the file. As you can see, this results in an additional virtual drive with the contents of the ISO. In case double-clicking wouldn't work, you can also right-click on the ISO and choose Mount. On that virtual drive, we have our required files, but these are read-only. Since we need to modify that file to bypass the hardware checks, we will need to take a copy of the contents of the ISO to a new folder on the desktop. Let me first create that folder. I'll call it 23H2. And then we can simply drag the contents of the mounted ISO to that new folder. After all files are copied, you can unmount the ISO by right-clicking on the virtual drive and choosing Eject. If you're low on space, you can now also delete the downloaded ISO file from your downloads folder. From here, we will only work with that copy of the files which you made on the desktop. If you would try to run the installation without any modifications at this point, this is what you would see. You can see the setup application running the checking your PC step for some time, and then comes back with the same information as we've seen before, and we're not allowed to continue. So, to work around that, as I mentioned, we'll modify that single file that is responsible for that check. So, navigate to the sources folder in the copy of the files on the desktop, and here, find a file called app-razor-res.dll. Right-click on it and choose Open With. Click Show Apps and then choose Notepad from the list. This brings up the binary contents of the file. There is no need to understand or read this. Just press Ctrl+A or go to Edit Select All and press the Backspace or Delete button to delete everything that's in there. Then save the file and quit Notepad. That's all it takes. So let's navigate back to 23H2 and run setup. On the first screen, make sure you click on Change How Setup Downloads Updates and then choose for Not Right Now. This will prevent the setup application from re-downloading the file that we modified. Click Next now, and as you can see, the checking your PC step only takes a very short time and doesn't complain anymore, simply because we removed the contents of that DLL file. Click Accept here, and eventually you should end up with the ready to install screen. This is what you need to get here. Install Windows 11 and keep personal files and apps. If you don't get the option to keep your files and apps, something went wrong, and in most cases, this is due to the earlier mentioned mismatch with the language. This is how that would look like, and as you can see, this is also clarified as well at the bottom of that window. All we need to do now is to click Install and then be patient. After roughly 30 minutes on this hardware, we are greeted with our fresh Windows 11 desktop. Let's take a look at Settings, System, About now. As you can see, we've successfully upgraded our Windows 10 installation to Windows 11 23H2. WinVir shows us the same information. At this point, you can safely delete the copy of the installation files which we made on the desktop, as they are no longer needed, and they take up quite some space. If you would have kept the downloaded ISO file in your downloads folder, you can delete that one as well. And while we navigate to that downloads folder, we can see that we are definitely on 23H2, as we have the new browser-like features available in File Explorer. We can also check the options for taskbar behavior over here. Since 23H2, it allows you again to not hide labels or combine taskbar buttons. And after aligning the start button to the left, this finally goes back to the way I've always liked it. Nice to see that this is available out of the box again. And to finish the video, let me also answer a question which many of you might have regarding updates. Let me go to Windows Update and click on Check for Updates. As you can see, as has been the case with earlier versions of Windows 11 on unsupported hardware as well, updates are coming in perfectly fine here, so no need to worry about that. That was it for the video. Thanks a lot for watching. Let me know how this worked for you, and if you would have any questions, let me know in the comments, and I'll do my best to provide an answer. If you have liked this video, a thumbs up is always nice, and if you're into this kind of videos, feel free to subscribe to my channel, of course. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.